like that, you know. See how I do.
Welcome. This is KT, and you're listening to the Jamaica Funk Show. Tonight, we got a great show planned for you. This month, the month of March, happens to be National Women's Month. And so tonight, we're going to honor someone near and dear to me. She's my co-host. Her name just happens to be Miss Johanna Bright. And when we come back, we're going to talk to her, and she's going to tell us about what she does, which she's a poet and an author of, I think, 5 books. So I'm looking forward to speaking with her and whatever else we talk about, because she and I just have a tendency to get into long, drawn-out conversations about stuff that's going on in the world because we're so passionate about it. So basically, until we get to that point, I want you all to sit back, relax, and get ready for some shona, mama shut your mouth, reggae music. Well, Irie Mon.
Brawling with the chrome 44 revolver, fat rubber grip make the angle broader. Dog on a squeeze on the trigger little harder. Use finger play man run them out faster. Chrome hammer kicker musty tula musty passer. 44 caliber them high and ball ya. The governor a open your head pon the plaza. Big tree shoot up some rifle with marker. Bad man no afraid and no crime stop caller. Bad man no park with no boy for your talker. Bumbo hole dead from your distant brother. Shoot up your corner dash with pot water. People a ball a hawks with that calfa. Jenna Ram start fuck your fat data. And from a beer tough chat dem a alpha. Man just blego de piranha.
Sting a man dem
blego de piranha.
Brawling
blego de piranha.
While dem a kill when we
blego de piranha. Blego de blego blego de piranha. Blego blego de blego de piranha. Blego 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 de piranha.
Fourth generation
blego de piranha.
Blego
the piranha, Zambia walk with the Kalashnikov. Plotting the clip, then a clip no banana. Broke down the back, get the SK shorter. Bust me gun sweet when the chick a little softer. And man no love party, man no flosser. Anytime when people see the piranha, them know somebody a drop and a go under. Bad man no coward like big pussy Sarah. Bad man bust head and make it fly far. Jungle is ready from Jenna to the harder. With some fresh irons off of the harbor. Boy get kidnapped, tie up and torture. Melt up your skin, pussy with the fire starcher. Make step anywhere you tell your dog. Broad here light now, flip you till the darker. Man just grip, blego de piranha.
Sting a man dem
blego de piranha.
Brawling
blego de piranha.
While dem a kill when we
blego de piranha. Blego de blego blego de piranha. Blego blego de blego de piranha. Blego 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 de piranha.
Fourth generation
blego de piranha.
Copy and sting dem
blego de piranha.
Sting a man dem
blego de piranha.
Brawling brawling
blego de piranha.
While dem a kill when we
blego de piranha. Blego de blego blego de piranha. Blego 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 de piranha. Blego 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 de piranha.
Fourth generation
blego de piranha.
Don't worry,
was sounding good. He said, come on and stir it up. You're listening to the Jamaica Funk Show. I'm KT. And tonight our guest host will be none other than Miss Johanna Bright. Give it up for Miss Jo. Hey, Jo, how you doing, babe?
Hey, KT, what's up? Hello, people.
Girl, I'm going to tell you, it's like this is National Women's Month, and what greater of a woman to honor than my co-host? You know? I mean, girl, you do such great things. I mean, an author of how many books? Is it five? Okay.
Well, not authors. I've written four, but one is a book of short stories.
Oh, okay. Okay. And then you are a poet, so you do the spoken word, correct?
Yes, I do.
All right. So, I mean, you know, what better way to honor my co-host in this a perfect time?
Mm-hmm. And for some reason, I went on this crazy rant, but, you know, on one of my rants, I was like, can we get to stop talking about the current administration and give National Women's Month a shot? You know, we should be talking about the current administration and all of their profiles. We haven't been able to hear one thing about the wonderful things that women have done.
Well, I know for a fact that women are doing some great things. I mean, look at both of us. We're both women, and we're up to some great stuff. I mean, you know, we're as they call them, pseudo journalists. Hey. Absolutely. 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 And then we do the show together. Our video. Yes, yes, our podcast. We do have a podcast, guys, on JamaicaFunkShow.com. And we're on YouTube. And you know, so much for what's going on in America. I don't even give a care no more because, you know, I'm quite frankly tired. Every day I wake up, I hear something different. So I have made a commitment to myself that I'm not going to focus on that, but I'm going to focus on what I'm present to, and that is the greatness that we as women bring to the world that we never get recognized for, or if we do, it's like half-assed, you know?
Right. The hierarchy in America, probably around the world, I really don't know because it's so commonplace that we just sort of skim over it in conversation, but the hierarchy in the United States of America is white men, white female, black man, black female. And no matter which way you slice it, women are always second or third. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So, but you know what the motto is, behind every great man is a great woman.
Yes, yes, there is. Behind every great man, there's definitely a great woman. As a matter of fact, even before the man came, the woman was here because we're the one that gave life to the man. I don't care what any historical quote-unquote supposed facts, because the one thing I know about those historical supposed facts, they were created by men, and they were created to glorify men, not women. And I really get that, you know, since we're the ones that bear the seed that comes onto the planet that's called either male or female, I get that we obviously had to come first. I just...
Look at it, we all, people all, and a lot of, you know, look at all here in the same no matter how anybody wants to look at it, somehow we got relegated to second class. And I don't know when or how that happened, but it did. And, you know, we've just been trying to, you know, get our voice heard and respect. You know what I'm saying?
Well, you know, the one thing that I've noticed about being a human being and living in this country and living in the world, for that matter, is that one of the things I've noticed is that all over the world, men tend to dominate women, and they tend to dominate us by convincing us that we're the weaker sex. And I really don't get how can we possibly be so weak when, you know, once again, going back to creation, we have babies. We go through labor. I don't know a man on the planet who has ever endured a labor pain, you know.
And that's a popular thing right there, ain't it?
Yeah. 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 Yeah, without us, they wouldn't exist, you know. And so I think what it is I think it's a fear that that they have to look strong. They have to look strong, you know, and by making us and making us seem weaker. Yeah, well, by making us seem weaker, then, you know, they seem stronger. I mean, that's what they do to, they done it to the black folks.
And quite frankly, they can have that physical power. They can have that physical power. I don't really know who.
Yeah.
They can have it. I really don't care. Because if it's got to be somebody that coats that bar, they can have it. I do not want to.
I think it's more than physical power. It's more of a mental power also, because they play mental games with us. Like I was saying, they done it to the black folks. They done it to the American Indians. They're doing it to the Spanish, you know, or Hispanics, I should say, you know, here in America. All of those problems that they were having, it was a bunch of women who took care of those problems, which was, you know, it the irony of it is that they were not only women, they were black women who took care of those problems. I mean, we're the ones that taught them how to use the computer, you know, and
go back to my
absolutely.
Mm-hmm. And I ain't gonna lie, I saw the version that they came out with at the theater then, but it was a good version. Anyway, I was floored. I knew that there was a black woman who had done the math that put a man on the moon.
Mm-hmm.
But when I saw the depiction in theater, the intellect of these women, the men, this was a black woman who was elevated over everybody. Her boss was referring to her. She stood in front of all those men, and she came up with a calculation and solved the problem of trajectory.
Yes.
And they couldn't figure out. I was like, yes. And this is why our kitchen books are so screwed up today. Because men refuse to admit that they lost and won't ask for directions.
Yeah. Well, listen, we're going to stop here for a moment. We're going to get some sweet reggae music going. So, and we'll be back with a little bit more Joe Bright. She's got some poetry for us. And we got a little bit more conversation for you. So sit back, relax, and enjoy some sweet, sweet, sweet reggae music.
When you say you need me,
I love you.
Your mom, boy, I adore you. Boy, I adore you.
Alright, so fine, Miss Girl, you're so fine. Think we really need to spend more time. See clear, God, I love you, I'm not blind. If it was a felony, me charge for the crime. Girl, don't play with my mind. I will be there, will never treat you unkindly. I'm yours, so girl, just be mine. Tell you, say me love you from a long, long time.
When you say you love me, you know I love you more.
Yeah.
When you say you need me, you know I need you more. Boy, I adore you. Boy, I adore you.
Yeah, baby girl, from the start you have a place in my heart. In my mind, soul, body, in my thought. You know that this is real from the beginning. We never depart. Solid cause we never fall short. Baby, you adore me, I adore you. Whatever the case is, you know I will be there for you. And I will never ignore you. God, just remember one song.
Sweet, sweet, sweet love.
I tell them reggae make you rock, make want to hear the sound. Woyoy, woyoy, woyoy. See man and woman, them a rock. Everybody be a vibe, nobody and no dead stock. No pain when music hits, Robert Nesta said that. So pull up that one you're from top. That one your name, reggae make you rock, rock, rock. Reggae make you rock some more. I say rubber, rubber, dub, rubber,
dub.
Been listening to G Sharp, man. That boy, he's a bad mamma jamma. Let's just say that, because he be knowing what he be doing when it comes down to mixing that music up. Joe,
yeah.
You got some poetry for us? It's called what? Okay. Yeah, this is what you know about being a woman.
Yeah, yeah. So this is what I know about being a woman. I was born female. That made me a woman. My mom called me her baby girl. I'm a sister to my brother, a mother to my daughter, and a wife to my husband. I'm a girlfriend, a hated enemy. Counselor, mediator, and yeah, sometimes an instigator that makes me a woman. When I was in the fifth grade, boys were interested in what was underneath girls' dresses, so they hid pieces of rope urine between the laces of their dress shoes and made them excuses being close to me and my girlfriend, Teresa, so they could look up in between our legs. And when we found out what they were doing, we hit them softly on the back with the black cards of our hands, and they would run away and friends before the prodigal come up. That gave me power like a woman. On the first day of middle school and the end of summer vacation, I wore my first bra, got my period. I decided to wear a scoop neck, choker cap, short sleeve top with a denim black skirt and platform sandals. I was new to my class, and when I entered, I met a bunch of strange faces. That's not mine. But I was the only girl who decided to wear a long skirt, so I stood out. I felt different because all the other girls wore mini skirts or jeans, and that made me feel like a woman. In high school, things changed. The dynamics of my life changed. I didn't have the same friends as me. New teachers, the school, the classes, the boys, the lens, the attitude. In one blazing moment, when we all sat together for the first time, you could smell it in the air. It was thick as if we were all taking deep breaths at the same time. You know, the sexual tension, the anticipation of the day, and then swoop. The door opened, and it was like a fat draft of air got sucked out of the room. We could see the fumes of air being sucked into our lungs as he put down his folder and pen and introduced himself. I am Mr. Homeroom Teacher. You fill in the blank. And from this day forward, you will be referred to as Mr. or Miss, whatever your last name is. That made me think of myself as a woman. So I fell in love with him in my senior year. He had a choice of girls, in my opinion. Our offices were next to each other, had been for 2 years. We shared lunch and classes together, but she never really noticed me until one day. I decided to wear my nicest pants, prettiest shoes, curled my hair tight, wore red lipstick, and a thick, confident smile. I was determined to get to see me as more than just this girl next to his wife. And when he stood next to me that day, I looked at him from the corner of my eye and gave him a smile and said, "Hi." It was the longest 5 seconds of my life. But that was the plan. Just give him a good long look at me and stop her way. In homeroom, he asked for a pen and I gave him one and turned around and said not to notice her, but secretly hoping he would say something more than the same. He turned back to me and asked if I was sitting with anyone in mind. We sat together from that day on, became best friends. I was in love with him. My first love, my first lover, father, my first child, my first broken heart. That made me think like a woman. I'm 19 years old now, and I'm in state college. I'm a mom, an employee, I'm smoking weed, experimenting with coke. I've had 3 other lovers. I got my own place. My baby daddy has bailed on me with no reason why, and I'm alone and scared. There's so much to do and no time to do anything with any real chance of the outcome. But I'm the only one making the decisions now. So I go with my gut and take chances. Don't work out, the rest, I still don't know. But every day is different, and I just keep moving, juggling my day and night, day after day. This makes me a woman. The day I got married, to the husband I have today, to the children I bore this marriage, the meals I cook, to the doctors I trained, the people I kissed, tears I pulled, arguments I've adjudicated, tears I've cried, jobs I've held in my spare time, if they ever really existed. Volunteer work, play days, parties, nights out, lights out, day breaks, breakfasts, lunches, dinner, snacks, invitations, and life appreciation. From paying bills and managing business deals, taking sports games, shopping first for shoes, for bras, for pads, and suits, and coffees, and flowers, and baby showers, and more weddings, and first gray hairs, and retirement plans, and long nights of rest, and coffee, and curtains, and office professionals, and laundry, climbing up tools, lines, and teams. But all I really wanted was to get in the hot tub of warm for summer, listen to my favorite tunes while holding my drink of twerk, and refills waiting. I'm knocking at the door, asking for the shoes, socks, or just a tea. From the moment I entered this world as a doctor, it's a girl that made me a woman. And I could go on, but little bit more the same. Same days, the bleed into each other because as I live each day, I have to make decisions off the cuff. It has nothing to do with the careful timetable of events that are turning in my calendar. The things that I plan to do and the things I have to do every day. Not to be confused with the things that come up every day that require my immediate attention and how I put most things on the back burner to simmer until the water drains out. Because while I know how to juggle today, tomorrow, and right now, I want to take the pot off the fire and rescue the vestiges of my day so I can wake up fresh from this morning and begin again. These things make me act like a woman. These are some of the things that have brought the woman out of me. The pressure of the students are late baby going to find me, they personify me. So this is back now when I'm still here. And one day my daughter will read this and look at her life and these words will not make her a woman, but she will look at her own life and find the things that have made her who the woman she is and will be one day.
All right. Thank you, Joe. That was nice. That was nice, I tell you. you know, you never really think about all those things that we do as a woman. But, you know, we bring a whole lot to the table, you know. And sometimes we bring that too. You know, there's an old saying that says a man that gets a good woman got something. I think I read that somewhere in the Bible. Yes.
You know, and that's a truism that's ever there was one ever written.
Mm-hmm. I agree with you.
And what's that number? The happy wife, happy life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all of these little truisms that go around, and yet one could see me. My last damn nerve could be tortured.
Yeah, well, you know how that go. Well, you know, there are some men out there who are very, very good men. They're good men. They really get who their woman is for them and what she does and what she brings to the table. But, you know, you don't see a whole lot of them. And so, you know, this ain't a male bashing session. We're not bashing any men. So I just want to acknowledge that there are good men out there. And, yes, yes, there are good men out of there. And you know, they say they only take a few bad apples to spoil a bunch. So, and I truly believe in that, you know, I've literally seen that literally happen. So I truly believe that. But, you know, the great thing about this month being National Women's Month, is that we really get to focus in on what women have contributed. You know, I mean, I look at women like Oprah Winfrey, who is someone that I truly admire. And she just today gave away a whole bunch of $700 juicers on Instagram, you know. I mean, you know, this woman, she never ceases to amaze me in her generosity. Just her talent. I mean, she's really one hell of a talented woman. I was watching the show Greenleaf. Have you seen that show?
No, unfortunately, I don't have that channel.
Well, if
I
you
know I need to get a fire extinguisher.
Yeah, well, that would be good, but since you ain't got one, I mean, that is what it is. But
right.
It is actually in a very good show. Very, very good show. I thought it was going to be more fire and brimstone. But what it is it shows the humanity of people in the pulpit. And she's got some really great female actors like Lynn Whitfield. You know, I mean, I love myself some Lynn Whitfield. She is really one of the greats who I don't even think she's ever been acknowledged with any substantial award for the talents that she brings to the table. You know, I mean, you know, there are several different women that is in this show, and then I look at the show. How to Get Away with Murder. Look at Viola Davis.
This woman, Viola.
Yes.
Has been in the business a long time.
Yes.
She has literally dug and worked and clawed, quite literally, and taken her way to the top.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But that woman has been in some very compelling any actor or any actress roles, rather. She's an actual actress.
Mm-hmm.
The realism that she brings to the character on how to get away with murder.
Yes.
Yes,
and wait a minute. And her two supporting actresses, those two young ladies that are, excuse me, that are on the show with her. I mean, you know, actually not two, three. There are three of them on there.
Yes, they are. That's
excuse me.
And I don't know that I'm horrible when it comes to remembering names.
Yes, yes. Those are the ones that I'm talking about.
Yes, I am floored by their performance.
Yes.
Because they bring such a realism to it. You go, you know what? As hard as these people on this doggone show are trying to bring themselves out of the shit show that they have found themselves in, no matter what they do, no matter what avenue they take, life still takes this horrible turn. It's like Murphy's Law. You can go wrong, it will.
Well, you know what, Joe? It's been a slice talking with you. I want you to tell people, other than the Jamaica Funk Show, where can they find you at?
Oh, honey, I'd like to tell people to just go ahead and Google me. Google Joe Brett, and I don't want to search for my resume. Or you can find me at mamayaya.wixsite.com/ my website.
Well, Joe, thank you so much, sweetheart, for being on the show today. And guys, I'm going to sign off along with Joe so y'all can get these last few minutes of some great reggae music. But until we get together again, remember, there is no me without you. So thank you for being here. If you want to hear this, you can go to iHeartRadio, look at type in Jamaica Funk Show. You can also go to jamaicafunkshow.com and see us, and on YouTube. So until we hang out again tomorrow, well, Irie Mon.
'Cause every day I've been working hard. So the wicked them want me fall. And all they try me, I try, the system won't give I a chance. But I will never let a wicked get me down. And I refuse to ever wear it from. If from the most I sit up on the throne, Emperor Selassie, I wear the triple crown. I guess say, through the time it gets so hard. See, I get me fuck up my heart from abroad. And me know say little more that enough separation I go on. But I will never let the system get me down. And I refuse to ever wear it from. If from the most I sit up on the trap. Emperor Selassie, I Emmanuel, tell you say. Me juggling in the streets. A Babylon bomb me down when I decanter. Me goose them a cease. Them all assign me a thief. And cuff on me and the right away, them all a fling me in a jeep. Me a laugh is a please. But once I in me see the wiki, them group of them mama canna peep. Them glad to see me a weep. But the most I put me back on me feet. So I arise. Every day I've been working at. So the wiki them want me fun. And all they try me, I try the system, won't give I a chance. But I will never let a wiki get me down. And I refuse to ever wear it from. And from the most I sit up on the throne. Emperor Selassie, I wear the triple crown. I can say, right here, no time I get so hard. See, I get me fuck up my yard from abroad. And me no say little more, say enough separation I go on. But I should never let the system get me down. And I refuse to ever wear it from. And from the most I sit upon the truck. Emperor Selassie, Emmanuel, tell you say, enough will grudge you. But them don't know the pain or the struggles or the things they've been through. Them want to take you for food. But I love, I still spread to everyone and just cut and go through. Them are just dirty and it's so bad mind. Well, when you're dead, we go one side and rejoice. Enough try for side for you, no one see you shine. Them love it when you're begging of time. We criticize.
And in the evening, it's just the way you put the goodie on me. Ooh, makes me want it all the time. Ooh, you captivate me with your eyes, yeah. Ooh, and the way you ride it blows my mind. I can't go a moment without thinking about it. Oh, yeah. Lady, you're truly one of a kind. You keep me coming every evening. Every week I can't believe it. Like I've never known love before. The way you put it on me, lady.
The way you put it on me.
It makes me wanna make a baby with you. Oh, oh, and your loving drives me crazy. Like I've never known love before. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Your loving gets me so high. It's got me feeling so divine. I'm telling you. There's nothing I would rather.
Passion rising. Oh, what a feeling when your body's close up. Close upon me and I feel the heat rising. It's showing all in your eyes. That you love when we're riding to the sunlight. Nothing can compare to how it feels right. Feels so right.
Oh, the way you love me in the morning.
Love me in the morning.
You keep it coming every evening.
Coming every evening.
Baby, we got to believe it. Like yeah, I've never known love. A baby,
baby.
Who under loving drives me crazy,
crazy.
Like I've never known love before. Oh, oh. Your loving gets me so high,
so
got me feeling so divine. I'm telling you, there's nothing I would rather than to love you forever.
Yeah. 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 Keisha, hey, Keisha.